Andrew McCart, IFL TV in association with MTK Global. I'm here in Manchester for a long time because Frampton fight with me up with the victorious Michael Conlon. Michael, you're just up the ring there. Good, solid 10 rounds, which you needed, and you've won your first title. How do you assess your performance?
I felt it was a good fight, you know, a good progression fight. I'm happy enough. I've got now a belt for Christmas. I felt, you know, there was questions asked to me there which need answered. I felt they answered them. First southpaw, first time going 10 rounds. And you know, it's all good. I'm happy. I think I had a smooth enough fight.
It's always good to take a new belt home to the kids as well. Your son's probably too young to even recognise that you've got that belt, but it's always nice to have that before Christmas, isn't it? Like a nice new shiny belt for the mantelpiece.
Yeah, that's it. You know what I mean? First belt.
Of many?
No, first of many. But I'm letting the sport pick up belts, I guess. I'm going to go all the way, and you know, this is just a step in the right direction for me. But you know, as I say, it's nice to have, and you know, it's what you need to do to start to reach the top level, pick up all these little titles and tasks on the way.
Again. The 10th round that you had him hurt, he showed his toughness in there. Do you believe that if it was when there was a 12 round fight, maybe you could have
got
him out
there? I think so. You could see from like 7 on, it was starting to really hurt him. And you could see then actually, like, he started to come forward a bit more, and I was able to start to counter punch more, which I'm a natural counter puncher, so you know, I felt sometimes I was pressing the fight and getting caught silly shots. But that's just
the progression. Well, as we touched on just off camera there, like, you need somebody that's going to come the same attitude as you, the same will to win sort of thing, going to throw punches so you can maybe slip them shots. Is that going to be like who you're going to look for as your next opponent?
Nah, listen, I'm going to let that top rank sort who I fight next, but listen, it's. What I am is a natural counter puncher. I showed tonight I can fight as an orthodox fighter, a southpaw fighter, an aggressive fighter, and a counter puncher. So, you know, I showed I have all the aspects of boxing, but there is a lot of fine tuning needed, and I will do that. But at the same time, I'm happy. You know, it was a good solid performance for me going into Christmas and finishing the year off as 10-0.
I spoke to Jamie. 20 minutes ago, and I was speaking to him about how do you match somebody like you go forward. I mean, like, you've won that belt then, so, and you've beat a tough opponent in Jason Cunningham, and I mentioned like Vladimir Nikitin, who's obviously well documented about what happened in Rio and all this sort of stuff. Is that a fight that you might visit in 2019?
Yeah, I think so. I think it's definitely going to happen. Top Rank have talked about it. It's been talked about for a long time now, and I hope it happens. The sooner the better for me. And you know, when it does happen, I'll be ready, and I have no bad blood against Vladimir, so I'm not really going to create any fake beef, but there is a score that they can settle, and I will settle it.
Is that too soon for you?
Shout it to H-Man, yeah, let's get him in.
The best hype man in the business.
H-Man, right? Yeah. H-Man!
There we go.
Shout it, Charlene Beat.
Yeah, definitely. I've already sung his praises.
Charlene.
Best bad man in the business.
Charlene.
Yes.
No, just a bad man.
I lost my train of thought. I was just thinking that you're a bit more advanced in your pro career than Vladimir. So I suppose my question is, does he want to fight with you? Has that been talked about?
Yeah,
I know he's been top rank, and I know he's fought in your
only reason Vladimir's saying with top rank. Frank, how's it going? Thank you, appreciate it.
Last round, my God.
I know. The only reason Vladimir said with Top Rank is to fight me. No, let's put ourselves in Vladimir's shoes. You know, he's not gonna.
He's got a score to sell with you.
He's got, yeah, that's what I mean. Yeah, put yourself in his shoes. He's got beef with me more than anything because he went and won a bronze medal in the Olympics, and the only thing he's ever going to be remembered for is winning controversially over me, and he wants to fix that. And I know that's why he's saying with Top Rank. I know he sees that's his money fighting boxing. And the sooner the better for him, because I don't believe that he'll be keeping his own for a long time.
Well, again, it's probably a daft question asking you when you're just fresh out the ring, but another fight that I spoke to a couple of people on Twitter that would like to see you in the ring with Shakur Stevenson. Yeah. I mean, you're both the top rank, you're the same weight. Is that one of the fights that top rank might hold off until one of you is maybe a world champion?
I think this is top rank, they obviously send us together, they know there's a storyline there which will match up at, and we will face each other someday, whether it's for world title or whether it's not, but we definitely will.
Is this true that Bob Arum said that this is you and Shakur Stevenson is the modern day Duran and Chinaman? Is that a true statement? Yeah,
I did say that.
Good man. So I guess 2018 you've been a busy man, and you've got, again,
it's been a hard year. Let's look at it. Like, I've had 5 fights. My last one before this one was in October, and I came straight back in the training camp. I had a week off, had Halloween with my family, and came back straight back in the camp.
You were out in June as well, in Belfast, wasn't you? So it was June.
Yeah, and I've just had a baby boy in July, so it's been very, very hard for me to be away from my kids. This camp especially, I'll be honest, I love Christmas more than any time of the year. And for me being away,
you love Christmas.
I love it more than anything. And this was the hardest camp. I felt fucking depressed at times in this camp because I was away for so long. But you know, that's the part of being a professional boxer.
Well, you say you like Christmas, and I'm no doubt in the future your kids are going to see this video, so you got to sing every Christmas carol. I know the Coogan was trying to get you, so give them a wee number.
What one do you want?
I quite like the Pogues, Fairy Tale of New York.
It was Christmas Eve, babe. In the drunk tank, an old man said to me, won't see another one. And then he sang a song.
Oh, X Factor, here we come! X Factor, we're coming, blood!
Just thank God you didn't say Britain's Got Talent.
No! I'll never say that!
That would have been some shit on me.
Right, Michael,
I don't think I'm a good singer, by the way.
That was good.
Go and record.
Check the comments that we posted.
Are you nervous for good comments, Vlad? I'm going to say one's coming.
You heard it here, guys. Well, Michael, thanks for this, Michael TV, and enjoy the rest of your Christmas. Merry Christmas to you and Happy New Year, brother. Thanks, Michael.